मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स, दिस इज सबरी हियर। टुडे आई विल कवर समथिंग विद रिगार्ड टू ऑप्शंस। वी कवर अबाउट लॉन्ग कॉल टुडे। एज आई मेंशन, लॉन्ग कॉल इज लाइक बाइंग अ कॉल। लॉन्ग मीन्स लॉन्ग एंड शॉर्ट आर द जार्गन्स यूज्ड फॉर लॉन्ग इज फॉर बाइंग, शॉर्ट इज फॉर सेलिंग। लॉन्ग कॉल मीन्स बाइंग कॉल, short call means selling call. What does call mean? Earlier I explained in my previous video about call. Let me take an example. Right now we are in lockdown period. We expect the price of chicken, a pound of chicken, will go up after the lockdown period, maybe in June. End of June, we expect the price of chicken may go up. Okay, right now the price of chicken is $10. For example, I go to Kroger. Kroger is giving a coupon for $1. $1 coupon that is valid till end of June. If I go with this $1 chicken coupon, they can give you a pound of chicken for $10. So that $1 chicken coupon is the long call option. So for example, in our chicken example, how to buy a long call, how to open a long call, just buy to open it. How to close the long call, just sell to close it. My rights, exercise the call to buy the equity at the strike price. What is strike price? Here I have an example for gold ETF. The current price is $164, $164. All the future prices and all the past prices are listed down here. So all these prices are strike price. For example, in our chicken example, the current price of chicken is $10. Kroger is selling various coupon to buy a pound of chicken. For example, they are selling a coupon for 50 cents to buy $15 per pound chicken. If I pay $1, they are giving me a coupon to buy $10 a pound of chicken. And if I pay $1.50 per chicken coupon, they can give same 1 pound chicken for $15. So this $5, $10, $15 are strike prices. So all the future prices of that specific stock or chicken are, and all the past prices are listed down. So those are called strike prices. I'll explain you with an example so it will be easy for you to understand. In the further slides I have some examples. So what is my right? I can go with that $1 coupon to Kroger to buy chicken for $10, 1 pound chicken. That is one of my right. Second right, I can sell that coupon. I have a $1 coupon. I can sell that coupon. So for instance, in future, by the end of June, if chicken prices goes up to $15, I can sell my coupon, $1 coupon. So anybody goes with that $1 coupon to Kroger, they can get 1 pound of chicken for $10. Though it is $15, they can buy it for $10 because of that coupon. So the demand for coupon will be more, the price value for coupon will be more. So I can sell my coupon as it is. I can resell the coupon. And I may let the coupon to expire. For example, I have the $1 chicken coupon. For example, by the end of June, if the chicken price comes from $10 to $5, I go to Kroger by the end of June with that $1 coupon to buy $1 pound chicken for $10. It doesn't make sense, right? The actual price is only $5. Why should I use this coupon and buy $1 chicken for $10? Doesn't make sense. So the coupon will expire, lose its value. So when I am going long call or buying call, what is my expectation? The price will go up. Very bullish trend. And basic application, there are few more jargons. All the jargons are highlighted in bold. At the money, out of the money, and in the money. Let me explain that, then I come here. So in this gold example, so right now the gold price is 163.93. The price, the strike price, here we have strikes. The strike price that is close to the current price is called at the money. All the future prices for long call, what is the expectation? Very bullish. The price may, I expect the price to go up. So all, what is my expectation for gold? It is 164. I expect it goes up to 165, 166 or something like that. So all the future prices are called out of the money. And all the past prices are called in the money. So in the money are the past gold prices. Out of the money are all the future gold prices I expect. So this is only for call. Put, I'll come up later. Just right now let us focus only for call. So how to, what is the basic application? I buy a call option for at the money. In our example for gold, I buy it for $4.40, to 164 strike, or slightly out of the money, maybe 165 or something like that. That is the ideal way of buying call, long call option. And at least the value, the time value should be 45 days. Options, you know, every options contract have a duration. For example, in our gold example, my options contract will expire in 33 days. But what is the ideal scenario is, have a time value for 45 days. Buy option contract that expires after 45 days. Minimum, there should be a time value of 45 days. What is time decay? Time decay, like you are buying a gallon of milk and keeping it in your home. What happens for the milk after 30 days? Or when it comes near to expiration, it will decay, right? Like the value of the milk will go down. When you buy a milk which have expiry date of more than 1 month, the value will be more. Or when you buy a gallon of milk where the expiry date is tomorrow or in next couple of days, the value will be less because it's about to decay. So same applies for options as well. If we have longer duration, the value of the option will be more. If the time pass, the value goes down. What is this, the type of trade? This is a debit trade. So for buying a pound of chicken with a strike price of $10, I'm going to pay $1. I'm going to buy the $1 coupon. So I'm paying out of my pocket. So it's a debit trade. So what is the risk? The $1 I'm paying for the chicken is the risk. If the chicken price goes from $10 to $15, I use this $1 coupon and the Kroger person give me the chicken for $10. Even if it is $15, he is going to give it to me for $10 because I have that coupon. So the risk, if the chicken price goes below $10, still I got to buy it for $10. So for example, if chicken price goes to $5, if I go with that coupon, still I got to buy the chicken for $10. It doesn't make sense, right? Why somebody go with the coupon and buy the chicken for $10? Then the value of the coupon is, there is no value for the coupon. So that is the risk, is the amount I pay for the coupon is the risk, $1. That is the risk. And reward is unlimited. If chicken price goes to $100, Still, I use the $1 coupon and I can buy the chicken for $10, even if it goes for $100. So the risk is, the reward is unlimited. What is the break even? The cost I paid for the coupon is $1, and when I go to the shop and buy the chicken with that coupon for $10, so the total price for the chicken $10 plus the debit I paid $1, the total price for me is $11. If the chicken price goes to $12, then it's profitable for me. If the chicken price is $10, it will not be profitable. If the chicken price is $11, still it's not profitable. Only if it crosses $11, that is $10 plus $1, that is $11, then it is profitable for me. What are the primary exit and secondary exits? So whenever we enter the trade, we need to plan for exits. Only after planning exits, the right way to enter the trade. So my basic ideal way of entering long call is, if it happens to be I'm getting 20% profit, I'll exit the trade. And the other option is, I can exercise the option contract and take the ownership of the stock. In our example, I use the $1 coupon, Kroger coupon, to buy $10 chicken, 1 pound chicken, $10. So I take that, I take the ownership of it, and whatever the market price is, I can sell that. But if I don't have a capital to buy $10, just an example, if you don't have capital to buy $10, then just simply I can sell that coupon for more price because the demand is more. I can exit the trade. Secondary exit, if I'm making a loss of 50%, I'll come out of the trade. So if the chicken price goes down, my value of the coupon will also comes down. If it comes down by 50%, then I exit the trade. The one more option is adjust to spread trade. This is another kind of option strategy. I'll explain in our future videos. So we'll take an example. I took that gold example. Right now the gold price is 164. This is the at the money call. So all the future prices 165, 166, 167 are out of the money calls. 163, 162, 161, 160 are in the money calls. This scenario is only for call. Put, it's completely different. I'll explain later. So what is the maximum reward I get? Unlimited. If gold price goes to by the end of June, if the gold price goes to $200 per share, then I can, with this option, I can buy the gold for 164 and I can sell it for 200. So the limit, the reward is unlimited. The maximum risk is $4.40. So this is the price I'm going to pay, $4.40. So actually one option contract contains 100 options in it. So if I'm buying one option contract for 164 strike, I need to pay $4.40 multiplied by 100 options. That is $440. So what will be the primary exit? 20% return on investment. If the gold price goes up and if I get 20% on top of my initial premium paid, that is $4.40, and if the price is $5.28, I sell it and come out of it. Secondary exit, if there is 50% loss, if the premium I paid $4.40 is only $2.20 gold price come down, then I'll close the trade, take the 50% loss, and I'll come out of the trade. So this is a risk profile for long call option, call buy option. The down price is called, is the strike prices, share price. And here I have the profit. For example, right now, this is the current price of the stock. So if it goes up, just see only this thin line. Ignore this thin line. If it goes above 168, I'll be making profit. Why? Because what is the break even? Break even means what? When I'm going to make profit, when my profit will be more than zero, little more than zero. The total of strike price plus the price I'm paying for the option, that is $4.40. So $164 plus $4.40 will be my break even, that is 168.40 will be my break even. So if it crosses 168.40, I'm going to make profit. What is the maximum risk? $4.40. If the gold price comes down to $100, still my risk will be only $4.40, or for one option contract it will be options contract, it will be $440. Alright. So what is the advantage and limitation of a long call? Here in our example, we have a gold ETF at $164 per share. So if I'm owning the ETF, I'm purchasing 100 share at $164. So I'm paying $16,400. If gold price goes to zero, then the maximum risk for me is $16,400. So similarly, if I'm using options, okay, before going to option, for assume future, for example, end of June, if the gold price is increased by $6. So $164 is right now, my value of one ETF or one share is $170. So I'm making $6 profit. So 6 divided by 164 multiplied by 100, that is my rate of return on investment, 3.65%. Similarly, let us see what will be the benefit or advantage if I'm using a long call or call by option. Purchasing a call option contract at $4.40 per share, the same 164 strike, so I'm going to pay $440. So my maximum risk will be $440 only. So if the gold price increased by $6, it goes from 164 to 170, my option value increases from $4.40 to $7.40. Here I am assuming that for all the at the money strike is means what? The current strike price at which the share is trading right now. So gold shares is trading 164. So this 164 is at the money. So the delta for 164 will be always, for at the money options, the delta will be always around 50%. So you see 0.51, right? So what the understanding is, delta means what? If there is $1 increase in the share, my option value will increase by 50 cents. So in our example, our share value increased by $6. So if $1 increase, my option value increased by 50 cents. $2 option value increased by $1. $3 option value increased by $1.50. $6 my option value increases by $3. So $4.40 plus $3, $7.40. So what is the return on investment? 3 divided by 4.40 multiplied by 100, I'm going to get 68% rate of return. Here for the 100 shares, I paid $16,400. My return on investment is only $3.65. But for the same commitment, I'm just paid only $4.40, but $440. But my return on investment is 68%. What I'm going to, the maximum risk here is 16,400. Here I'm going to lose only $440. Right? This is the advantage of long call. Once we know the direction, it's good to go with a long call. And the disadvantages with the long call is the time decay. By the end of June, if the gold ETF price is only $64, it neither move up nor down, stand still, sideways. So I'm not going to lose anything there. My 16,400 will stay as it is. But in my option, long call option, if there is no change in the price, it is neither bullish nor bearish, then my price, I'm going to lose this $440. Because what I say, there is a time decay concept in options. Like I given you an example of milk, right? If I keep the milk in my home till my expiry, the value of the milk will come down because of time. Same applies to options as well. There should be movement in long call option. Movement in which direction? Upward direction. Only then we can benefit out of this long call. So this is the advantage and limitations of long call. Thank you, friends. Keep sharing this video to your friends if you like. If you like, hit the thumbs up button. Thank you. Next, I'll come with a short call option video. See you next time. Bye-bye.